just been seeing the film Four Horsemen by director and writer of the documentary, Roche Ashcroft. You have just delivered a broadside on the economic system with this documentary, and you have not made a film about these greedy Wall Street guys, but you have actually shown a person like me who doesn't understand economics how it works and what is going on. And you say in the beginning there that there's a collective delusion going on about how the system works. What is that delusion?
It would be very easy to go out and make a film about bankers and how bad they are. And I don't believe that to be the case. I think bankers operate within a system that they're given to operate within, and that they create profit within that system. So the key for us was to make a movie about the system in which they operate. And that system is underpinned by something called neoclassical economics. And what we, the collective delusion that you speak of, is that we've all lived under this system thinking that it's going to deliver every rich and in the world and every bit of wealth and market equilibrium and all these things, and it hasn't. And my question is, why hasn't it? And that was the starting point for the film.
And you start very well going back in history and showing how empires rise and fall, and seeing signs in our times that actually we are nearing some kind of shift that has to happen. And I understand that you tried to get this film distributed at major channels in England, BBC, and they said no. Why do they say no?
Firstly, let's just talk about how empires rise and fall. And one of the reasons is that at the end of the empire, hubris takes over, and people think that they can, let's say, bypass natural law. Economics is not divorced from nature. And here in Sweden, I think you are more aware of that than maybe the people in the City of London, who just see natural resources as land or as an expense that they can utilise to get profit. So that's the first thing. Divorcing economics from natural law ultimately ends every civilization. The second thing is, it's tough to give a documentary that talks about the economic system to a mainstream broadcaster, which is the documentary is 97 minutes long. So they have very set slots, and I think that they are reluctant to move those slots and give an audience something that's possibly a little bit more challenging than what we've seen so far.
So this is obviously a very important film, because many people in the audience, it was very well received by the audience, and they really felt that, yes, you're putting it all together in a very comprehensive way, in a very pedagogic way. But how are you going to get this film out?
Well, it's being sold around the world in Scandinavia. The Scandinavians, both buyers and audiences, really like this. And that warms my heart, really, because I think that Scandinavia is in many ways very progressive. If you look, take your environmental record, it's excellent in comparison to Europe and certainly the UK. So it's being sold here, also being sold through Europe and South America, interestingly. Very, very interested. It's specifically Chile. Because they've been, of course, at the hands of the neoclassical economic doctrine for years, and they've seen the havoc that that has brought to their people. So countries who want it really go for it, and I'm sure that that will continue over the next 6 months to a year.
And the story here is not about capitalism is bad. It's more like you're looking for some way to reform capitalism.
Quite. I mean, no one wants a call to socialism, but everyone wants an economic system that distributes opportunity equally. And at the moment, what we have is a total monopoly on opportunity, which is allowing bankers and financiers to rip off the real economy. So what we're looking at is the systemic problems. And I'd just say this, and Gillian Tett says it in the film. She's the assistant editor at the Financial Times. If you remove a few bad apples from the economic system, it doesn't then suddenly mean that the economic system is revitalised and will go on fine. It has to be a wholesale change. And the only way that wholesale change happens is if people get engaged in the democratic process and enforce their elected leaders to take action. So it's the moral obligation really lies with audiences. And as we've seen in the Q&As, which go on, as you saw, for a long, long time, people are A, very young, who are engaged in these issues, and B, they really want to know how best to go about changing it. And that, to me, from a filmmaker's point of view and the rest of the team, is incredibly exciting.
Thank you. Roche Ashcroft from the documentary Four Horsemen.
People think that they can, let's say, bypass natural law. Now, economics is not divorced from nature. And here in Sweden, I think you are more aware of that than maybe the people in the City of London, who just see natural resources as land or as an expense that they can utilise to get profit. So that's the first thing. Divorcing economics from natural law ultimately ends every civilisation. The second thing is, it's tough to give a documentary that talks about the economic system to a mainstream broadcaster, which is not, the documentary is 97 minutes long. So they have very set slots, and I think that they are reluctant to move those slots and give an audience something that's possibly a little bit more challenging than what we've seen so far.
So this is obviously a very important film because many people... We have just been seeing the film Four Horsemen by director and writer of the documentary, Ross Ashcroft. You have just delivered a broadside on the economic system with this documentary, and you have not made a film about these greedy Wall Street guys, but you have actually shown a person like me who doesn't understand economics how it works and what is going on. And you say in the beginning there that there's a collective delusion going on about how the system works. What is that delusion?
It would be very easy to go out and make a film about bankers and how bad they are. And I don't believe that to be the case. I think bankers operate within a system that they're given to operate within, and that they create profit within that system. So the key for us was to make a movie about the system in which they operate. And that system is underpinned by something called neoclassical economics. And what we, the collective delusion that you speak of, is that we've all lived under this system, thinking that it's going to deliver every rich and in the world and every bit of wealth and market equilibrium and all these things, and it hasn't. And my question is, why hasn't it? And that was the starting point for the film.
And you start very well going back in history and showing how empires rise and fall, and seeing signs in our times that actually we are nearing some kind of shift that has to happen. And I understand that you tried to get this film distributed at major channels in England, BBC, and they said no. Why do they say no?
Firstly, let's just talk about how empires rise and fall. And one of the reasons is that at the end of the empire, hubris takes over. And
people in the audience, it was very well received by the audience, and they really felt that, yes, you're putting it all together in a very comprehensive way, in a very pedagogic way. But how are you going to get this film out?
Well, it's being sold around the world in Scandinavia. The Scandinavians, both buyers and audiences, really like this. And that warms my heart, really, because I think that Scandinavia is in many ways very progressive. If you look, take your environmental record, it's excellent in comparison to Europe and certainly the UK. So it's being sold here, also being sold through Europe and South America, interestingly. Very, very interested. It's specifically Chile. Because they've been, of course, at the hands of the neoclassical economic doctrine for years, and they've seen the havoc that that has brought to their people. So countries who want it really go for it, and I'm sure that that will continue over the next 6 months to a year.
And the story here is not about capitalism is bad. It's more like you're looking for some way to reform capitalism.
Quite. I mean, no one wants a call to socialism. Well, no one, but everyone wants an economic system that distributes opportunity equally. And at the moment, what we have is a total monopoly on opportunity, which is allowing bankers and financiers to rip off the real economy. So what we're looking at is the systemic problems. And I'd just say this, and Gillian Tett says it in the film. She's the assistant editor at the Financial Times. If you remove a few bad apples from the economic system, it doesn't then suddenly mean that the economic system is revitalised and will go on fine. It has to be a wholesale change. And the only way that wholesale change happens is if people get engaged in the democratic process.